CIET-NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 3.
Good morning children. How are you doing all? I hope you all are enjoying the mathematical activities and games that we are doing together. I am Pooja Rana, your maths teacher. So today, I have one more very interesting topic for you. Are you excited? Yay! Tell me children, up to how many numbers can you count? Tell me. I know you must be saying 100 or above. Today, our topic is fun with numbers. And as the name says it all, we will do lots of fun with the numbers. So, are you ready for the fun and the games? I know you must be excited, and I am excited too. So, let us begin. Dear children, I have a story for you. And this is the story from Class 3, Textbook Maths Magic, Chapter 2. Chapter's name is Fun with Numbers. If you are having textbook with you, you can open it. And if you don't have the book, you don't need to bother. I am here to explain you what is in the chapter. So children, I have a story for you. Actually, I have converted the incident of the book in a story. So if you don't have book, no worry. There are 5 friends, Radhika, Gauri, Vicky, Indra and Sunil. They are playing in a garden. They all are having lots of fun and playing many games. Meanwhile, one of them saw a tamarind tree. Do you know what does tamarind tree means? Anyone of you know? Yes, it is Imli tree. Radhika called everyone there and showed them tamarind seeds on the ground. Then all of them started collecting the seeds. They make a game of it. They said, "Let us start collecting the seeds." Then they started collecting the tamarind seeds. Do you want to know who collected how much seeds? Okay, I will tell you. Children, you can note down the data that I am telling you if you have notebook with you. Or if you don't have notebooks with you, you can keep it in your mind. Yes, Radhika collected 24 seeds. Vicky collected 42 seeds. Gauri collected 47 seeds. Sunil collected 38 seeds. And Indra collected 54 seeds. So now children, I want to ask you a few questions. You can note down the number of seeds collected them by again. I repeat, Radhika has 24 seeds. Sunil has 38 seeds. Vicky has 42 seeds. Gauri has 47 seeds. And Indra has 54 seeds. I hope you all have noted down. Now, tell me, who collected the most seeds? Who have the maximum number of seeds? You will have to look at the numbers. I can repeat them for you. Radhika is having 24 seeds. Vicky is having 42 seeds. Gauri has 24. Vicky has 42. Sunil has 38 and Indra has 54. Now tell me who has the most seeds? Yes, you all are right. Indra has most seeds. Indra has collected how much seeds? Come on, tell me. Yes, Indra has 54 seeds. Wow, you are going great. Next question. How much seeds Sunil should collect to be equal to Vicky? I repeat, how much seeds or how much more seeds Sunil should collect to be equal to Vicky? Now, how will you solve this problem? Think. You will have to find out first how much number of seeds Sunil has collected. So, we will see Sunil has 38 seeds. And now, we will see how many seeds does Vicky have. Vicky has 42 seeds. So, think how many more seeds does Sunil need. Think. You might have subtracted 38 from 42. There was some other way to think. Yes, some of you could have taken forward jumps to reach the number 42. And some of you could have taken backward jump to reach the number 38. Now you must be thinking, what is this forward jumping and backward jumping? So, for solving this problem, to do it mentally, we can use the number line, the imaginary number line. Question was, or the problem was, that how much more seeds Sunil need to be equal to Vicky? So, Sunil is having 38 seeds and he want to get equal to 42. So, if we see 38 is near to number 40, if we take 2 jump forward from 38 to 40 and then again 2 more jump to reach the number 42. So, 2 jump plus 2 jump, we have taken 4 jumps to reach the number 42. So, did you observe? We didn't use subtraction here. What we did? We only jumped forward. So, isn't it a great interesting fact? Now, you must be thinking, what is this backward jumping? If we see how many seeds does Sunil has? He has 38 seeds. And he want to go where? 42 seeds. And if we see how many seeds does Vicky has? Vicky has 42 seeds. If we jump backward from 42 to reach number 38, then how many backward jump do we need? Yes, first we will take 2 backward jump to reach 40 and then again 2 backward jump to reach 38. Again we took 4 backward jump to reach number 38. So, that's how we reach to the solution. Vicky needs 4 more tamarind seeds to be equal to Vicky. So, did you like an interesting ways to solve the subtraction question? Yes, I know you must be liking it. Now, I have one more problem. Think if Radhika gets 6 more seeds. Then how many seeds will she have now? Now to solve this question, we will have to look how many seeds does Radhika has. Yes, Radhika has 24 seeds. So, what will we do? Yes, we will add 6 more seeds to 24. If Radhika gets 6 more seeds, then she will be having 30 seeds. 24 plus 6 is equal to 30. We can do it mentally again with the help of imaginary number line. How? Yes, forward jumping. From 24, we have to reach to number 30. So, we can take 2 jumps, or we can take forward 3 plus 3 jumps, or we can jump to first, take 1 jump to reach 25, then take jump of 5 to reach 30. So, we reach to number 30. Now, one more problem for you. How many children have more than 40 seeds? I repeat, how many children have more than 40 seeds? Think. For this, we will have to look at all the number of seeds collected. Radhika has 24 seeds. Is it less than 40? Yes, it is. Gauri has 47 seeds, which is more than 40. Sunil has 38 seeds. So, is 38 less than 40 or more than 40? Yes, 38 is lesser than 40. Indra has 54 seeds. Now, tell me, is the number 54 more than 40 or less than 40? Think. Yes, 54 is more than 40. Vicky has 42 seeds. Now tell me, is 42 greater than 40 or lesser than 40? Think. Yes, 42 is more than 40. So, out of 5 friends, 3 friends have collected seeds more than 40. One more problem. Sunil has 2 seeds less than 40. Sunil has 2 seeds less than 40. Now tell me, who has 2 seeds more than 40? Think. Yes, Vicky has 42 seeds, which is 2 more than 40. But let us see, Sunil has 2 seeds less than 40. So, how many seeds does Sunil has? Yes, Sunil is having 38 seeds with him. Very good going, children. Next problem. Who needs 3 more seeds to have 50? Who needs 2 more seeds to have 50? Who needs 3 more seeds to have 50? Yes, you are right. Gauri has 47 seeds with her. And if she gets 3 more seeds, then she will be having 50 seeds. Now, Who collected the least seeds? Who collected the least seeds? Tell me. Think. Yes, Radhika collected the least seeds. So children, did you like the story and its questions? I hope you liked them. In this discussion, I asked you few questions about making the number 240 or 250, and you reached on that number by counting instead of addition or subtraction. So we took the help of the counting. That's how we play with the number. So let us play a game. It is a guessing game. We have to guess or we have to estimate the number. So are you ready? Let us begin. So the game name is, can you guess the number? Guess the number of matchsticks in a matchstick box. Okay, I am giving you something to think. Is it less than 30 or is it more than 30? Think of the matchbox. How many matchsticks can be there in the matchbox? Have you ever counted them? No. Okay, you can guess it. Yes, you are right. It is more than 30. Very good. Next, guess the number of teeth in your mouth. Hey, don't do cheating. You can't count. I have said you to guess. Guess the number of teeth in the mouth. Are they less than 20 or more than 20? Think, don't count. Yes, they are more than 20. Wow, you all are having more than 20 teeth in your mouth. It is great. Next question. Guess the number of seeds in an apple. Have you ever eaten any apple? Yes, we all should have an apple a day so the doctor keeps away from us. So, have you ever counted the seeds in an apple? Okay, no need to count. We are guessing here. Now tell me, have you ever seen a bicycle? Yes, you must have seen a bicycle. Have you ever seen its tire? Bicycle tires. Yes, there are some spokes in the tire. Have you ever seen them? There are straight lines crossing each other. Those are called spokes. Okay, now you have to guess the number of spokes in the cycle tire. Are they less than 20 or more than 20? Think of the cycle tire. Now think of the spokes in it. Now guess. Yes, correct. They are more than 20. You are going great. Now, have you ever seen rainbow in the sky? Yes. Now, guess the number of colors in the rainbow. Are they less than 10 or more than 10? Yes, it was easy. They are less than 10. There are 7 colors in the rainbow. Now, guess the number of stars in the sky. Oh, it is difficult. You have to guess the number of the stars in the sky. Now I will have to give you a bigger number. Are they more than 100 or less than 100? Think. Yes, you are right. They are more than 100. In fact, they are many more. Or can they be counted? Have you ever think of counting them? How many of you tried to count the stars in the sky? I know all of you have done it once. Even I had tried also, but never counted them correctly. So, children, do you know the numbers beyond 100? Oh, great! Let us imagine how the 100 things will look like. Have you ever seen 100 people in a room? Think 100 people in a room. No. Okay. Imagine your classroom. Imagine your classroom. Now tell me, can 100 children assemble there in the classroom? Think and tell me. Yes, you are right. 100 children cannot be assembled in your classroom. Now tell me, is it possible to put 100 books in your classroom? Think, can 100 books be assembled in your classroom? Yes, it can be done easily. Okay, now think, can 100 books be assembled on your bench? Again, I repeat the question, can 100 books assembled or can be put on your bench? Yes, you are right. They can be kept on the bench. Yes, but how? How will you put them? Tell me. Yes, you are right. By grouping them. Okay. Now tell me, how will you make groups of the 100 books? Think. In how many ways we can make or we can arrange the 100 books on the bench? Yes, we can make 10 bundles of the books. We will put 10 books, tower of 10 books, then again 10 books, then again 10 books. Or is there any other way? Yes, we can make 20 books together. We can keep 20 books again, tower of 20 books, 20 plus 20 plus 20 plus 20 and plus 20. Very good. Is there any other way? Yes, it can be done. 50 books in the one tower and 50 books in the other tower. Very good. You all are doing so great. Now, children, I have some activity for you which you can do at your home. And I believe that you will enjoy them too. So, listen to me carefully. So, children, Today, we will do an activity at home. You can take any cereal or grain, for example, gram seeds, wheat, rice, or kidney beans in a bowl. You can take these seeds from your mother from the kitchen or from your father from the kitchen. Now, take the seeds in a bowl. Now, you have to make a guess that how many seeds can be taken in your one fist. Children, do you know the meaning of the fist? Fist is the front part of your palm when you grab it, when you take something in your palm and close it. That is called fist. So, you have to make a guess that how many seeds can be taken in your one fist. Now, take the fist of the grains and put them in other bowl and count them. Now think how far or near your guess was, or was your guess exact the same number that you have taken in your fist. One more game. If you have a plant in your home or near you, first make a guess of the number of the leaves in the plant and then count its leaves. See your guess how far or near it was. It will be fun. I hope you like the topic and activities we did today. Children, keep exploring, keep doing new activities and keep growing. See you again. Goodbye.
So friends, you were just listening to the series Dhwani Shala. Production assistants Meenakshi Kukreti and Tanu Gupta. Recorded by Shanu Muksim and Vikas Sangwan. Produced by Ajit Horo. This program is brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.